Big-brained peasant, fight. 34th of February, 1067, CUE, Eastland. Zork Kruzel, liberated. Empire freed from tyranny of magic. Gone are the days of turning castles into fudge and eggs into ripe guano. Gone are the gruels and granola, the flatness and the foolishness. Today the magic wars are over.
Shun magic, and shun the appearance of magic, shun everything, and then shun shunning.
So says the Grand Inquisitor from atop Flathead Mesa, where the grateful masses throng to welcome Inquisition troops to newly occupied Fort Fuzo. The third Dungeon Master has accepted the Inquisitor's generous offer of a permanent vacation. Today, the Dungeon Master read a brief but impassioned statement in support of the transitional Inquisition government. Rumors that the Dungeon Master is leading a so-called magic resistance are entirely false. In other news, the standoff at the Enchanters Guild ended peacefully last week when the Enchanters were freed from themselves by caring Inquisition troops. Concerned citizens everywhere search high and low for hidden scrolls and magic contraband, voluntarily purging themselves of the worst excesses of the magic revolution. And finally, at tomorrow's ceremony, the Grand Inquisitor is expected to announce a radical new mind-numbing technology that will implement his visionary One Point of Life program.
Never forget who is the boss of you. Me! I am the boss of you! I am the boss of you! I am the boss of you! I am the boss of you!
Curfew will begin in 1 second. Curfew! Curfew has begun. Curfew began 1 second ago. Curfew began 5 seconds ago. Curfew began 10 seconds ago. All citizens are reminded to be quiet, to attend tomorrow's ceremony at the Flathead Mesa. Is a paid announcement. The Grand Inquisitor rolls! This message was brought to you by Robots Electric.
No. Fish heads! Fish heads! Get your roly-poly fish heads!
Trying to steal my fish? Get your own!
A proclamation for the betterment of society.
Look, it's past curfew. You're lucky I don't turn you in just for hanging around outside my shop. Now get out of here!
Of our once largely feasible and only rather recently corrupted township of Fort Fuzo, which is to say, our persons of only the most excruciatingly and agreeably subservient natures, highly evolved moral sensibilities, and mental capabilities, the philosophically complex, the ethically the blindly obedient! Let it be known throughout our land, from the Westlands East to the Eastlands West, and all the other responsibilities. Any persons found, alleged, remembered, or known to be practicing magic of any variety, degree, nature, intention,
oh,
or color...
Oh, implementers. It's one of those adventurers again. Go away. We don't need any.
...tolerated, respected, invited to parties and celebrations, inclusive of, but not restricted to, curse day and otherwise. Will in plain fact...
Can't let you in. Sorry. Guess you'll have to die.
...incarcerated, fined, tried, tortured in time permits, and will be totemized, along with anyone they've ever met. Which is frankly a very bad
Oh, you're selling Parmesan machines! Oh, I've already got one. Go away.
This would be very nearly the bottom in the list of desirable ones. There is no magic in Zork.
Even if there were no curfew, I can't let you in! I'm completely nude!
Until those who dare attempt to restore the Black Heart have been contained. Lord Fuzel is hereby, from this day on and from this day back, ordered to obey in view of a penalty of totem... A strict curfew of sundown.
You one of them agitators, ain't you? We don't want none of your kind in Port Fuzel. You hear? The Inquisitor told us about agitators like you. Coming to town with all your big ideas. We don't want no ideas, you hear? Hey, it's past curfew. I want you people to get off my land. You trespass. Get lost! Want some biscuits?
Leader of the campaign against all horrid sorts of magic, the evening curfew is now in effect.
Now cut that out, you little creep. Shut your yapper and get out of my face. I don't like you, you see, and I don't know what I'm gonna do next. I'm a madman. I'm a madman, you hear?
This probably. In a world where justice is spellbound, in a time when magic is gone awry, one man will have the power to change and the will to lead the Magic Inquisition. Brought to you by Probaz Adventure Works the Arcade, a subsidiary of Probaz Electric.
Who is the boss of you?
Many actual wizards will harm you.
Me! I am the boss of you!
Go away! I don't want no trouble! Please! Go! Away!
Way! Self-containment in the post-magical age! Obey! Conform! Abstain! Ignore! Deny! Repress! Restrain! Bridle! Curb! Reduce! Repeat! Inform! Shun! Tell us! Tell us everything! Avoid flirtation, avoid libations, floss regularly, save often, walk briskly, step lively, think happy thoughts.
Oh, a poor soul trying to find some meager refuge from the Inquisition.
Go away!
You wouldn't be fishing for anything in particular now, would you? Because, see, I'm a fish and you're no fishing. So I gotta ask. You want a piece of me, Doc Boy? Or Doc Girl? I can't really tell, all you people look the same.
Just a reminder, all Fuzel households must be equipped with a standard Inquisition loudspeaker. As per standard Inquisition requirements, blaring standard Inquisition propaganda at all times, which is standard. Failure to comply will result in standard Inquisition consequences, which is to say, you will be totemized.
You're just getting your sea legs, so I'm gonna say it to you nice.
Don't drag your stinking hook through my stuff, okay?
Reports of a strange blue glow near the dock are grossly exaggerated. All citizens are warned to stay away under penalty of totemization.
You're just not getting it, are you? Maybe you don't speak the language.
Ikwe, Yore, and Anagan Shays!
The following is a paid announcement.
I can sit here as long as you can, friend. Yep, all day if need be. And I have a distinct advantage.
My entire underwater world is one gigantic fish toilet!
No autographs. I don't do that anymore. Now beat it. Scram. It's past curfew and I can't afford any trouble. Can't afford Jack. And I am Jack. I let you in, they bust me, you walk, I go to jail. No thanks. Go find yourself another patsy.
In a city where anything can happen, the one thing no one expects...
It's past curfew and I can't afford any trouble. Can't afford Jack. And I am Jack. That's all right. You keep it. Mead light. Do I look like the kind of a guy that drinks light mead?
All citizens are reminded, required, to attend tomorrow's ceremony at the Flathead Mesa.
Holy hungus. A genuine lantern. Looks like that one I had with me when I killed that troll with my rusty knife in Great Underground Adventure 4. These things are hard to come by. Nowadays, all you get are flashlights, courtesy Froba's electric. Whoa! Get in here! Go ahead. Heisted a whole crate off the Inquisition. Well, I know a guy who knows a guy who heisted a whole crate off the... And I paid him. Now, where's my wrench? Ah. Yeah, looks like this lamp has seen some action. Got a lot of carbon scoring here. Let's see if we can't just take a little. What's making a spark like that? You smell Spence weed?
Where am I?
Let me handle this. Nobody saw you come in with that lantern. Now, don't look at me like that. I'm not a real adventurer. Just played one on TV. Couldn't find my way out of a maze if you paid me. Well, maybe if you paid me a lot. Look, this thing is magic. It's been a while, but I know it when I see it. Trust me, you don't want this lamp. Now scram!
Stop by the Inquisition gift shop kiosk and take home a souvenir of your stay in Port Foozle. How about a talk to me?
Forget it. I'm not giving you that lamp. It's for your own good. And, mine. Forget it. I'm not giving you that lamp. It's for your own good. And, mine.
The Perils of Magic exhibit at the Inquisition headquarters has been closed temporarily. However, the totemized daily billboard is functioning correctly.
Fire! Fire!
Supposed to smoke it.
Aha! Arrest the vandal!
Oh, what a load of yipple dung. I've been set up.
Go ahead and read him his rights.
You have no rights.
Hey, you're Anthea Jack.
I'm a really big fan of yours. Remember that one time when you killed that thief who stole all your stuff?
Sure, pal, whatever you say.
That was first rate, bloody good.
Can I smite him?
Hey!
Oh, I believe Smith is. Smitation would be appropriate at this juncture. Go right ahead.
Oh, I get to smite Anthea Jack. Oh, the guys at headquarters aren't going to believe this.
Just a reminder. All Foozle households must be equipped with a standard Inquisition loudspeaker. As per standard Inquisition requirements, blaring standard Inquisition propaganda at all times, which is standard. Failure to comply
Hey, thanks for fishing me out of that crate. Don't think I could have taken another spawning season. And thanks for getting rid of that Jack guy, too. We got lots to talk about, but the introductions are gonna have to wait. Get me out of this place before anyone finds me. Hey, not here, okay? Let's get underground, then we'll talk. The underground. Much better. I'm Dalbaz. Dalbaz of Girth. They call me the Dungeon Master. Well, they used to, before I got stuck in this lantern. The job doesn't mean much nowadays, but I was a big deal about 100 years ago. Then magic is banished, and Yannick, the Grand Inquisitor, sprays me with Froboz electric wizard repellent. Suddenly, I'm torn from my body, floating helplessly, and I end up trapped in this piece of junk. Which brings me to you. What's your name? Okay, I'll just call you Ageless, Faceless, Gender-Neutral, Culturally Ambiguous Adventure Person. Afghan Cop, for short. Anyway, you gotta help me. Standard stuff, really. Save the Empire, return magic to the land, a little revenge if time permits. I'm a bit out of sorts at the moment, but I know just the person who could help us out. The Enchantress, Ygale. She's a bit flaky, but she's one heck of a spellcaster. And she always gives you free stuff when you talk to her. Let's ring her, shall we?
I am Ygale, lost Enchantress of the Empire. I come to you from the ethereal plains of Utri. I gotta get that. Do you mind? All right, let me go right to the point. This call's not cheap. The good news is there are three magic relics. Relics strong enough to bring magic back to the Empire. The bad news is they are lost or destroyed or something because, hello, no magic. Zip it! Take this spell book, adventurer. There is much magic hidden in the underground. If only you know how to look.
What did I tell you? A spell book. Let me give you a quick rundown. There are three types of magic spells. High magic is creation. Middle magic is enlightenment. Deep magic is transmutation. You pick up spells as you go along, and you write them into your spell book. We'll probably run across a few of each down here. There are spell scrolls stashed all over the underground. I just can't remember where. Oh, come on now. Look, we're safe down here. Even if you could make that climb, we'd be arrested in a matter of seconds. That appears to be your average everyday subway token. Naturally, it's lying in a bucket at the bottom of a well. Oh, it's our very first inventory item together. I wish I had a camera. Door's locked, huh? I'm not much of a hand with locks, but if you open the spell book... the energies of magic don't need to be separated right now. I'm sure they appreciate the sentiment, though. Bingo! Open sesame! A very nice piece of spellcasting, indeed. The crossroads of the great underground highway! My old stomping grounds! Oh, for the days when I could stomp. All the must-haves for the on-the-go adventurer. Well, I'd say this applies. Go on. It's stuck. Ah, the elusive umbrella tree. Aptly named for its umbrella-shaped blossoms. Violence never solved anything. Well, not everything. Okay, not this thing. Another vestige of the Inquisition. That tacky little souvenir is called a totem. They hold the imprisoned spirits of magical creatures. It's cheaper and easier than torture, and it's certainly much more space-efficient.
What was that? I heard that. Hello? Whoever you are.
It's me, Dalbaz. I got chased out of my body by the Grand Inquisitor and ended up stuck in his lamp. This here's Afghan cop. So how'd they get to you?
Well, I was just minding my own business, hanging out in the forest near Fuzul, and next thing you know, I'm cornered by a fierce posse. I mean, more of a phalanx, you would really call it. I mean, of about 100 Inquisition guards, you know? And I don't mean your average regular loose-sized guards. I mean, these were big guys. These were monsters. It took about, 50 of them to hold me down because mostly...
Oh, what's this? You're a knobby little something or other, aren't you? A scrawny, scaly runt of a kitty fish.
Ooh, there's... speak to the great dragon of the Empire with such insolence.
Behold the flames of my wrath.
Oh, beg mercy, my lord.
Oh, avert your eyes. My gaze is terrible. I am a dragon. Well, I'm sort of a dragon after a fashion, you know. If you dare look into my eyes, I'll turn you into, jelly.
Stone, you idiot, not jelly.
Ah, stone, right.
Unit red, shall we send back up?
You're gonna give me any trouble, runt? No, sir. Everything is under control here. Oh, dear.
Tough break. So you're out of commission, huh? Well, I'm sure this kindly adventurer won't mind the extra load.
Thanks.
Ah, the teleportation station. Fastest way to get around in the underground. It's a map. That's a permasuck machine. It'll suck onto anything, so don't go putting your mouth on it. Or anything else. Let's work through the logic. Stay with me here. Where would be a good place to use a subway token? Mead light? What kind of a drink is that? It'd take at least twice what you've got there to do anything. Not that the wizards of this universe use or condone the use of alcohol or any mind-altering substance in any way, shape, or form. I only know two people who smoke that brand of cigar. Well, one person, actually. That guy Antheria Jack. The other one is more of a house. That would be your basic little hammer. This sword appears to be of elven workmanship. Standard adventurer wear. You know the type. A token? A slot. But how to put it all together without my insert token into slot spell? I was just about to suggest that. The underground. It's a subway. It's a political movement. It's a subway and a political movement. Sounds like it's still operational, too.
Sheesh.
Okay, now you want to take the red line east to the yellow line, then switch off to the... I have no idea. This place looks sort of familiar. The rank undergrowth prevents eastward movement. Ah! Onward then! Into the foliage! That's my house! And this is my garden! I'm home! I'm home! I'm home! My gardening tools. Scroll, shovel. Shovel, scroll. That's an eggplant. Do you get it? Eggplant? No? All right. It's a snapdragon. This thing needs to take a chill pill. Watch it! Don't get too close!
Hey, baby. This is the Dungeon Master's home security system. You ain't getting in here, so don't even try.
I have a great home security system, but he's got some bad habits. Harry! It's me!
Come on, Harry, let me in.
Oh, yeah? Well, you got any ID? Me?
Do I look like I got any ID?
You look like a lamb. I don't care if you're the Dungeon Master himself. You're still not getting in here.
Now, what kind of self-respecting alarm system would let you do that?
Sorry, baby. Can't come in here.
That's an eggplant. Do you get it? Eggplant? No? All right. That's an eggplant. Do you get it? Eggplant? No? All right. Ah, my alma mater. The most prestigious spellcasting institution in all of Zork. And I was first in my class, too. If you want to get in, you're going to have to pass the entrance exam. The three pillars. They test your aptitude for visualization, pattern recognition, and clicking. GUE Tech, Eastlands. Boy, this takes me back. The glory days of enchanting. I can't remember a damn thing. Snacks, sweet snacks. What a welcome sight to the road-weary adventurer. I think some of these were here my freshman year.
Is an emergency magicatronic message from the Enchanter's broadcasting system. I am the wizard, Belbaz. This is probably not a test. Should a tyrannical anti-magic despot have in fact eliminated magic from the Empire, you must find the following three lost magic artifacts. If you find them, magic will return.
This is a magic university. These doors have all been Rezrov-proof. This is the main hallway one took to go to class. I've never been down it. This corridor goes on forever. It's almost as if it were infinite. The hallway becomes a small way.
You must find the skull of Yorick, which contains the soul of deep magic. The powerful skull has fueled wars, raised empires, toppled cities, and through it all remained quite shiny. The skull was stolen by a pack of grues near the historic White House in the year 948. You must find the Coconut of Quendor. It contains the magic knowledge of the Circle of Enchanters, knowledge enough to fill an entire coconut, hidden before magic was banished from the realm. It holds the power of high magic and makes, I'm told, one heck of a piña colada. The wizard Yigael set sail into the Great Sea with it in 966 GUE. It was never heard from again. You must find the missing cube of foundation, one of the 17 building blocks which form our existence. The cube that contains the power of middle magic was allegedly won in a game of double fanucci by the scoundrel Antharia Jack, proprietor of a gambling hall in Port Foozle. As the sources were intoxicated in the extreme, this information has never been verified. Search out the time tunnels. This is the sole purpose for which we built them eons ago. This has been an emergency magicatronic message from the Enchanter's broadcasting system. This has not been a test. If this had been a test, an annoying tone would have sounded. The tone would have sounded very much like this.
As you'll notice, the university doesn't exist in our space-time. It's in a parallel dimension called the Ethereal Planes of Atri, which we sorcerers share with snack cakes, former child stars, and people who own ferrets. Hey, free dirt! Let's dematerialize, shall we? That's more like it. Now, unless I'm mistaken, all you have to do is pick the place you want to go to, wait at the edge of the platform, and assume crash position. I guess I should warn you, the thing about the underground is that there were a few cutbacks, and then a few more. And then, well, they just never got around to installing the brakes!
Totemization? Good. Now, if you just be a lamb and sign this confession, it's a formality, really. You willingly agree to be eternally bound and totemized and so forth, blah, blah, blah. You violated the laws and or pointed suggestions of the Inquisition, etc., etc., etc.
No problem. Of course. There's a mistake here on line 17C.
Be a lamb, just sign in a line.
No, really, look, here, where it's supposed to say stand in line for 3 hours and then get totemized, it says pop the inspector worm. Oh, sorry.
Oh. I'll sign for you. Pink cup is yours. Have a nice day.
I'm remembering why I've always preferred teleporting. This is the stop for the famed Flood Control Dam Number 3. I believe it was quite the tourist attraction in times far distant. There it is, one of the crowning achievements on Lord Dimwit's platform. Look at me. It's my first time here. You're thinking outside the box. Snaps all around. Well, whatever. I guess a much-loved and irreplaceable 300-year-old national treasure is a small price to pay. Congratulations.
Number 57. 57. Go on then, in you go, 57.
Right, that's it. In you go, 57. I mean, don't you read something or, you know, say something?
Yes, I say, in you go, 57, and you go in.
Oh, well, come on, at least have a hug.
People! People! Oh, not again! Oh, that's it.
in these conditions.
So, am I getting totemized or what?
That was fun. Useless, but fun. That really clears the sinuses. Hey, Slim. What you reading? How to hypnotize yourself. Guess it worked. Watch out. Old Scratch plays for high stakes. 500 Zorkmids against eternal damnation. What I'm trying to say is maybe you ought to save. Cha-ching! 500 Zorkmids! 500 Zorkmid bill. Cash. Dinero. Moolah. Dough. Spondulix. Makes me all giggly. Can you hear it? Thousands of voices lamenting some hideous fate. Or maybe it's just me. Let's dematerialize, shall we? This place doesn't look safe. Well, that's just great. How are we going to get up there? Hundred Zorkmids. Let's just stuff those in a handy little sack, shall we? Look, an ice cream bar. Hey, look, there's a special treat inside. Well, what do you know? Another scroll. The Obadil scroll. Will not nusto, for novelty purposes only. They're just saying that, though. Put it through a spell checker and it'll work like any other. I hate it when that happens. That's Yannick's locker. That rat ant was my roommate here for 3 terms, before he became the pastor of disaster up in the above ground. He would have failed out first term if it weren't for me.
Look at this! Cheat notes! Crib sheets! He may run the Empire, but he's not quite Mensa material.
Prozork tablet. This stuff will mellow anything out. Animal, vegetable, or mineral. One Zorkmid. Don't go spending it all in one place. It's not called the temporary suck, is it? No, it's staying right here. Just where were you keeping that?
Permanent suck from Frobar's Electric. We don't make things that suck, we make things that suck permanently.
Looks like those Zork rocks fried the machine. This thing really does suck. Leave it here. Aha, the ever-tasty Zork rocks. A clever marketing of dangerously unstable spell residue with red food coloring to appeal to the kiddies.
Warning, warning, presence of cola beverage detected.
Let's find a safe home for this stuff, okay? These rocks are about to pop in a very big way, and I don't want to be next to them when they do. There you go. Crisis averted.
Look, this is my locker. That's my stuff. My books and my papers and my... Oh, I guess I should have washed those gym shorts. My student ID. Fortunately, I cast the turn embarrassing photo invisible spell on it. My lantern sense is tingling, warning me of danger. Oh, and your sword's glowing too.
Get away from me, bridge, you cretin! Fat lot of good that'll do ya! How do you think I got to be the six-armed invisible bridge guy in the first place? Somebody already beat you to it, me friend. Look at me, damn ya! I'm the six-armed invisible bridge guy! Nobody messes with the six-armed invisible bridge guy! So, you don't go messing with a man, Zipper! Bah, get away from me, bridge, you cretin! Pants! Bah, get away from me, bridge, you cretin!
You gained 86 experience points and found a healing potion. Oops, wrong kind of dungeon master. I like your style. Splendid job. The spell checker. You used to have to wait in line for hours to use this thing. I guess we can cut to the front of the line now.
Spell named Bebert is not yet imbued. Imbuing spell. Imbuing is complete.
The Bebert spell gives the appearance of inclement weather. I use it for family reunions.
Spell named Odebill is soggy. Drying spell. Drawing is complete.
The Obadil spell looks good as new.
There, there. Hush, hush. Let those
those photosynthetic neuroses just ooze on out of you. This just doesn't seem fair. Effective, maybe, but terribly unfair. The Zimdor spell triplicates quantities of intoxicating libations. The Froboz Magic Alcoholic Beverage Company had it regulated, so it can't be nustoed into your spellbook. You know why they call it a snapdragon? Because it'll chomp on anything that gets within tongue's distance, which is just one reason why we should get rid of this thing ASAP! Mead light? What kind of a drink is that? It'd take at least twice what you've got there to do anything. Not that the wizards of this universe use or condone the use of alcohol or any mind-altering substance in any way, shape, or form. Now you're talking. 36 gloops of mead light would be sot the heartiest of the hearty.
Nothing like a good stogie. Want some rye? Of course you do.
Oh, poor Harry. He starts with just one drink. One drink, he says. What can one teensy little drink do? And then another. And then another. And before you know it, my house is sloshed on the front lawn. There, there. He'll sleep it off. Shall we? Ah, well bees. They'd sooner saw their wings off than let anyone get at their honey. Very delicate olfactory senses. Though I doubt that's helpful to you in any way. What do you think, huh? This place has some nice appointments. I've always thought it could use a conversation pit, though. The walking castle. He sure has grown. I'm glad I started keeping him outside. My voicemail! A message! Yes! Somebody remembered me! Oh, 100 years ago.
Hello, this is Shona from Girth Publishing. We're finishing up the latest edition of Gluttonous Recipes of the Fat and Unemployed, and we seem to have some discrepancy over the specifications for your cocoa blend. First off, flatheady fudge is illegal contraband, not to mention a tad hard to come by, and we can't find anyone with the guts to go near a Quilby's nest. A bar of glazed hungus lard is just disgusting, and none of us can figure out what hot bugs are. And then there's this last thing, moss of Marilon. You don't really expect someone to go scraping for moss, do you? Look, we appreciate your submission, but if we can't reproduce your recipe, we can't expect anyone else to.
She has no idea what she's missing. Actually, neither do I. What's she talking about?
Hi, my name is Doug, and I'm calling with a fantastic offer from the Froboz Electric Publishing Company. If you subscribe to both Obedience Monthly and Conformer Reports today, you can qualify for...
Isn't that the fellow who used to do those Encyclopedia of Frobazica commercials?
Right. Hello. Yes. This is Snapple of the Guild of Bikers. That's Snapple, yes, two Fs. I've relocated and I live in the throat, actually, of the great watch dragon of the coconut. The one word, watch dragon. And there isn't normally a phone in my flat, except that my flatmate appears to have swallowed some sort of ship. Well, there's no accounting for, you know, digestive processes. But it appears to have once been a ship. And that's what we get out here, mostly ships and the like. But that's neither here nor there.
These are all 100 years old. Any poor fellow living in a dragon has probably been digested by now.
Right. Sorry, it's me again. Snaffle. Well, we've discussed all that, right? Now, anyways, I'm a baker by trade, which should be fairly clear by my name, Snaffle of the Guild of... Right. Anyways, since the end of all this magic business, I've had a devil of a time staying in business. I brought this up at the guild. We took a vote and all that, but nobody could help me, really. When a simple broth spell would fold the dough 83 times, I could make a profit. But now broth hardly works. When it does, well, it usually folds the dough too often, and the butter melts, or it doesn't come out the right size, or this...
Hold on for an important method. Has a phone call ever changed your life? This one quite possibly can. Probaz Data Institute would like to offer you...
Dalbaz of Earth.
A free trial subscription to the Inquisition Cranial Enema Program.
100 years of phone solicitor messages. There really should be a law. He knows you're here. I think he just doesn't like you. Wow, I've never gone inside him before. This is pretty gross. My room. Oh, the nights I spent in this room. Warm, cozy, secure, alone, bored, miserable, waiting for hour after sluggish hour to tick by. I guess I don't miss this place all that much. Looks like a torn piece of scroll. Secret mirror room, where I brought lusty nymphs for trysts. I mean, where I would have brought them if I had known any. That window leads out to my bed of trampoline plants. It's sort of an organic fire escape. How'd that get there? It's a time tunnel. I wouldn't do that if I were you. You're likely to come out pureed on the other side. They're not gonna like that. That's why people say, plants are a man's best friend, or whatever they say. I don't know any people. That would be the second half of the Snavig scroll. You've got both pieces of the spell, but you can't Nusto it when it's all ripped up like that. You gotta run it through a spell checker. Ugh! Hungus lard! Sweet Yorick, is that stuff ripe? It mixes well, though. The right ingredients can drown out the stench. Look at the way my little flying bugs light up. And they're hot! Can you feel it? It's like an oven in there. I call them hot bugs. It's a chunk of fudge from the remains of Flatheadia Castle. Strictly contraband, but it's some darn good fudge. A rare and tasty Quelby honeycomb.
spell named Snavig is torn. Repairing spell. Repair is complete.
Ah, Snavig. The trusty all-purpose shape-changer spell. Nice fix. That looks like, yep, it's moss of Marilon. There doesn't seem to be very much of it, though. Beautiful. That's plenty. It slices, it dices. Yes, folks, it's a combination mixer and houseplant all rolled into one. I call it the Chia Processor. Ah, the days when it was all as easy as saying tea. Earl Grey, hot. This recipe, if I remember correctly, works almost like a potion. Cocoa, hot and rich and murky, like a fresh compost pile. Oh, wow, talk about deja vu. The last time I got a whiff of this stuff, I was working on a new spell. It had to do with time tunnels. It's too dangerous to jump through them normally, but That's right. It let you send spirit essences through time. When they come out on the other end, they're back in their bodies. It's called Yastern. The cup's the best part, isn't it? Not me. You're the adventurer, I'm the lamp. I do the sidekick thing, make a few wisecracks, standard stuff. Whatever goes through there goes without me.
Hey, that's the White House, isn't it? Ooh, wow. Before it was condemned. Oh, sorry, pal. I can fly. I can complain, I can breathe fire. Okay, maybe I can't breathe fire, but I sure as Hades can't pull these boards off either. Oh, sorry, pal. With all due respect, I'm afraid that my hyperneurotic tendencies sort of mandate a strict adherence to state and federal law. Oops! I almost forgot. Down! Down! Oops! I almost forgot.
It's a direct line to the commissioner.
Thank you for calling the Hades Shuttle Service courtesy phone. Since the dawn of time, your choice for crossing over into the afterlife. To skip a message at any time, press 4. This service has recently undergone a retrofitting to ensure full ease of abuse, customer dissatisfaction, and user unfriendliness while inefficiently bringing you, the recently deceased, to your final destination. Before crossing, you'll need to answer a few simple questions using the touchtone pad. Press 1 for the list of questions. To press 3, please press 7. To hear these options again, call back and listen to them again. To press 4, hit the pound key. To return to the main menu, you're already there. Press 8 to press 1. To wait on hold, stay on the line. To press 6, press 2. For a list of numbers, count to 10. To press 7, press 5. To hear the answers, press 6. To press 0, press the star key. To hear these options backwards, press 9. To press the star key, press 0. Press 3, if you really want to. For all other inquiries, please, blah, 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 blah. You have correctly answered all the questions. Congratulations! A shuttle will be along shortly to transport you to Hades, where you will languidly spend the rest of eternity. Have a hell of a day.
Charon, the oarsman of the River Styx. Whoo-hoo! I don't know how he manages to generate a stink, but he most certainly does. Your sword's glowing blue! Let me try that again. Your sword's glowing blue!
666. Very cute.
You've got mail.
Blue glow. Sweet Yorick! Don't you know what it means when an elven sword glows blue? I don't know what it means in elven, but to us it means danger!
A letter opener! What strange device is this? Ah, an envelope. But how can we possibly open such a cleverly sealed device? Confound it!
Brilliant! Absolutely brilliant!
Let's cut the crap, okay? You got this, Spock. You know the drill. You're the adventurer. I'm your
basic two-headed guardian of Hades-type creature. You're looking for treasure, mana, crystals, red pages, blue pages, whatever.
It's all the same, really.
The point is, you want to get by.
They always do.
And we gotta kill you.
We always do.
There's a little banter, a little slaying, chop, 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 yada, yada, yada. And then I gotta string your entrails all over the place and make a big mess.
Do us both a favor. Beat it. That is, before we change our minds. Haven't you heard a word we've said?
That Charon guy will roll just about any moron across the river. Don't even start with a Sparky.
Now you look like us, which is an improvement, but you're still not getting by.
Oh, that's an interesting look. Interesting like Jojo the slime-faced boy is interesting.
Transmogrified yourself into his clone. If you're gonna do something, do it fast. You won't stay like this very long.
Taking your lunch break early, huh? Don't forget to punch out!
Hello! Brog like rocks. Rocks. Brog thinking about rocks. Brog thinking about rocks and how nice they are. Nice for his tummy.
Hi, my name's Dalbaz. I'm the one in the lantern. The person who's carrying us around hasn't given us a name, so I just use Afghan cop. I find it fits he, she, or it pretty well.
Brog am Brog.
Uh-huh. I never would have figured that out. So how'd you end up in that totem, big guy?
Nice cave. Cave, good place to hide. Hello, buttons. Brog finds a nice hiding place, no bad things will happen to him now. Bad guy squish Brog in thing. Brog thing now. Brog sitting here long time, being thing and thinking about rocks. Rocks.
Little archipelago. This is my idea of a vacation, a little fun, a little sun, and I don't have any nose cream. Hey, can we get a few drinks around here? The kind with the little umbrellas? That's an air pump. So, let's pump some air. Dear God, it's a dragon!
Hello? Hello? What's going on up there?
That would be a coconut. Oh yeah, the coconut of Gwendor! I was looking for that nut.
Actually, since you're there, maybe you could help me out. I'm trying to make myself a pina colada down here and I'm running short on ingredients. So I need to run to the store to pick up a coconut. If I throw you a rope, could you tie it to one of the dragon's teeth so I could climb up?
That's a rope, all right. Thanks, mate. You know, my hyperactive superego is composed of complex neuroses, you know, that usually keep me from doing things like touching a dragon's tooth!
Just hold the rope, please. Thanks, mate.
Oh, come on! I mean, you gotta be a moron to perform an impromptu root canal on a sleeping dragon. It just isn't done, I mean. Well, I'm not gonna dwell on it, but that was stupid.
You ever been stuffed in a dragon's nose? This ain't funny, you sick seafaring bastard!
out convenient. We could put something there.
You ever been stuffed in a dragon's nose?
She
this
blows!
Ain't funny, you bastard!
Hey, a blows up must come down. Oh, well, that was easy. All we had to do was tickle a freaking dragon, fly into his mouth, send a guy to his doom, and shoot an inflatable sea captain out of his nose. I wish everything in life was so simple. Come to Papa, you nut. Hey, nice joint. Now let's just stick this thingamabob in that thingamajigger and tango on out of here, okay? Ta-da! Good work, kid.
Haven't you heard a word we've said?
That Charon guy will roll just about any moron across the river.
Now you look like us, which is an improvement, but you're still not getting by.
That's a rope. That's a rope. A sword on a noose. I like that. It's like soap on a rope, only a little tougher to market.
Brog no like it here. Brog teeny bit scared.
I'm the bickering torch. That's what they call me anyways. I prefer to call myself a grande queso. All right, but I'm warning you. First sign of a gru and I'm doused, you hear me? Out like a light.
I'm the flickering torch.
I do flicker, and that's okay. I'm afraid of dark caves, and I've accepted that about myself. I'm hearing that you really enjoy rocks.
Brog eat rocks.
Everyone likes the flickering torch better than me.
Board's hurting, house. Leave house alone, Nails.
Was that a groove? Is this a dark cave? Did you hear one word I said to you? See ya, pal. I'm doused.
We're quite a team, aren't we, you and I? I wouldn't miss this for the world. As long as you're in this dank hole, I'll be burning right beside you every second of the way. Not a flicker in sight, my thick friend. Oh, dear. Oh, dear. I hope I'm not becoming codependent.
Yuck! No, no eat egg! Brog like rocks! Creamy quartz filling! Brog favorite flavor! Rocks! Brog like rocks! Oh, Brog tummy full! No more rocks today! Brog no dumb. That dumb. Hold still, little torch.
Is an egg ever really just an egg?
Brog not like eggs in a can. Brog not like them. Brog am. Brog do good. Whoops. Oh, Brog fro like girl Brog.
It's almost fun in a way, isn't it? All this jumping business when you get the hang of it. I'm not even thinking about the cruise. Oh dear, cruise.
Brog found skull. Now Brog need to get skull. Brog get it. Just need time. Brog no good. But Brog try. Brog get it. Just need time. Brog no good. But Brog get it. Just need time. Brog much better at this game. Easy. Good puzzle. Smart Brog. Castle is Brog's friend. Brog find nice home for Skull. Go to sleep, little Skull. Pretty castle. Pretty guts.
Grand Inquisitor.
They're rioting in the streets, you know. There's even talk of a magic rebellion. Those imbeciles. If only they knew how much I care.
Never tried just talking to them?
Everything's so messed up. I mean, that's not even the worst of it. I just killed my college roommate. Or at least I thought I did, but apparently some idiot is carting him around the underground in a magic lamp. My men don't... If my men don't find him soon, they could ruin everything.
Come on now. Don't cry, Mr. Inquisitor.
Yannick, please.
Yannick, you think you've got it bad? I let the love of my life slip through my fingers over a stupid game of strip, roof, fire, and water.
Well, at least you had one.
Never even knew her name. I'm gonna be crying too. Look, I wasn't gonna say this, but if I tell you where you can find that idiot and the lamp guy, that make you feel any better?
Jack, would you?
Two words, time tunnels. Didn't you ever see The Great Underground Adventure 3?
Time tunnels, of course.
Ah, forget it. Now, pull yourself together, man. This is embarrassing.
Of course. Ah. I'm sorry.
Now, come on. Where's that tyrannical madman? Hmm? Do the face. Give me that mean face. Ah. Now, where were we?
Guards.
Yes, sir.
Bring in the Froboz Electric Hungus Prop.
Right, let's go.
You pathetic fool.
That's my guy.
Very clever. I hope you can climb up there with all this junk you're carrying. See? We can do this whole adventure thing, you and I, and we... I've got a bad feeling about this. A sword on a noose. I like that. It's like soap on a rope, only a little tougher to market. Don't you remember the signs from Port Foozle? It's that totemizer machine, and it's powered up again. They must have discovered an alternative power source, like building treadmills at the local orphanage. Informative, yet deeply disturbing. Sorry I can't help. We never covered this in shop class. You think those cranky Inquisition creeps want us to be doing this? You think that creepy crank with a big swirly mustache wants us to be doing this?
Permaseal, another fine product from the Perma series.
Hey, what you planning to do with that switch, huh? You're not thinking of pulling it, are you? You're sitting on my head.
9,942 bottles of mead on the wall. 9,942 bottles of mead. You take one down and pass it around. 9,941 bottles of mead on the wall.
Hey, you guys! Down here! In the bin! Thanks. When they left me behind in the bin, I thought I was gonna be stuck here forever. Oh no. You guys are totems, too.
Yeah, we all got squished. What did you do?
I was part of the resistance. You know, the magic underground. There's a whole movement in the streets.
Ugh. Well, somebody better clean it up. You can get a pretty stiff fine for that sort of thing.
Now that's a rule I can live by.
And to think your people once ruled the Empire. Arrest the flathead.
Wait, it's not what you think.
Really? What am I thinking?
Gee, it's hard to tell. There's so much interference coming from your mustache. You're out of milk. And your pants are chafing you. And you're going to totemize every magic creature in the Empire. And here I thought that oppressing the regular folks was enough of a full-time job. Busy, busy, busy.
For you, I'll make the time. Take her to the totemizer.
What, over a bit of paint?
Well, listen, it doesn't matter what you do, telepath. Your species, like all magic, has been declared extinct. Take her to the totemizer!
What, no rack? No gallows? What kind of loser Inquisition is this?
It's attitude like that have made the House of Flathead what it is today! Fallen!
In 773 GUE, a local civil servant caused unspeakable devastation to the city of Marilon when he attempted to cast Zemdor, a spell that turns originals into triplicate, and accidentally cast Zimbor, a spell designed to turn one really big city into lots of tiny little ashes. He reportedly apologized to the city with the words, "Whoops, my bad." In the mid-10th century GUE, a group of rogue alchemists seeking the fifth element of the quintessence of immortality released a vengeful force known as the Nemesis. The Nemesis tormented innocence, and a great many less than innocence, when innocence could not be located, throughout the Eastland.
Thank you.
havoc struck Quendor when the Wizard of Frobars, the court magician of Lord Dimwit Flathead, accidentally transformed Dimwit's famed castle, Flatheadia, into a mountain of fudge. In one errant stroke of wayward magic, the wizard simultaneously destroyed both the skyline and the waistline of the House of Flathead. The history of Zork was rarely a chronological study until the Inquisition officially sealed the ancient network of time tunnels that runs beneath the Empire. History in Zork now happens but once, and there are, as the Quendorian schoolchildren are known to say, no backseat.
This looks like some kind of wacko communication device the guards here must use.
Yannick sure do like his toys, don't he?
I'd say the Inquisition has way too much time on its hands.
Sweet Yorick! God, does it feel great to get out and stretch! Look, it's Foozle! Minus a whole lot of barbed wire and a few redcoats running around. I remember these good old days, when we were between Inquisitions. Anybody home in there?
Hey! Oh, just your luck. It's ladies' night. Come on in and save me a dance. Whew.
I haven't danced in a long time.
I love the lovely ladies.
I'm beginning to sense this mission is fraught with peril.
I love to love the lovely ladies.
We get the point.
Breathe in, breathe out, in, out.
That's right, big boy. Just stick to the fundamentals.
Want some rye?
Of course you do.
Whoa. Sorry. High rollers only.
Hey.
You got the egg.
Yeah? So what did I win?
Nothing.
Hey, Floyd! Yeah, boss?
Get her, get her, get her. She's ready to play. Go get her.
You won a very special privilege. You get to go into the back room and, play with the high rollers.
What do you mean?
Follow me.
Hi.
He is cute. Too cute. Something must be wrong with him.
I'm Jack. You know. And there you, Jack. You probably remember me from my hit TV series, The Z Team.
Bingo. What a conceited pig.
Did I just say that out loud?
I was expecting you to be a conceited pig.
Me?
I think I said some chemistry.
We're going to play a high-stakes game of groove, fire, water. Floyd? Tell her about the house rules.
Oh, yeah, there's rules. Yeah, they're real easy. Groove drinks water, water puts out fire, and fire scares groove.
So what's the ante?
Floyd? Tell her about the ante.
Oh, yeah, there's an ante. You're wearing it.
Strip groove, fire, water.
That's right.
Unbelievable.
Floyd? You game?
Please, please, please be game.
Tell me something, Jack. Does this little game actually work with women?
You tell me.
I'm so pathetic.
Pathetic, but cute.
Okay, I'll give it a try.
Great. But I have to warn you. I haven't lost the game yet. Beginner's luck.
Aren't you going to take the hat off?
Nah, that's trademark.
I thought the cigar was.
That's a habit.
Ah, trusty fire. Crew, fire, crew, fire, crew, fire. Ah, trusty fire. She thinks I'm going to use water, so I'll use fire. But maybe that's just what she wants me to do. I'll play Gru. Come on, Jack. Keep it together. Play it cool. Just reach over and pull out the fire. I'm on to her now. She's trying to trick me into using fire again. Well, a little water action should douse her flame. Come on, Jack. Keep it together. Play it cool. Just reach over and pull out the fire. I'm drawing a blank here. I'll just go with Gru. Come on, Gru. Good old Gru. Come on, Jack. Keep it together. Play it cool. She thinks I'm going to use water, so I'll use fire. But maybe that's just what she wants me to do. I'll play Gru.
You lose, Muffet. Ante up. Oh, what's the matter? Lost your nerve?
Oh, me? Don't be ridiculous.
Yes, yes, I totally lost my nerve.
You know, I do have something else.
that's the Cuba Foundation. I've been looking everywhere for that.
Really?
Don't you love it when a plan comes together?
I should go. Goodbye, Jack.
But I don't even know your name! Oh. Of all the lousy, stinking meat joints and foozle, why'd she have to walk into mine?
Wow. Very sparkly. Not to mention anatomically correct. The whole place kind of says, I am magic, hear me roar.
I admire your resourcefulness, nearly as much as I pity your ignorance. You can't stop me. I'm the future.
And your history.
Throw history in jail, along with that other interloper. Now we'll see how the powerful magic rebellion comes to its pathetic end. Who's the magic now? Baby.
That's it. We get to take off early today. Wardle's staying to make sure that Antharian Jack guy doesn't get any smart ideas. We're free to leave.
Oh, want to go to the Mesa to check out that Inquisivision thing?
Oh, that sounds kind of boring.
Yeah, suppose I should go and water my plants anyways.
Yeah, good luck with that. I'll see you later.
Okay.
Bye-bye. Bye.
All right. Talk to you tomorrow.
Hey, you, over here, in the vent.
You? You know what they did to me because of you? You ever seen a hungus getting prod? But it ain't pretty. Time tunnels? What are you talking about? Okay, so I told him about the time tunnels. Look, the guy was crying. I panicked. Oh, come on, don't. Don't start. Not you two. He was gonna find you sooner or later. Here, blow your nose on this.
Where's your stuff?
Did you see me in there? And I did all my own stunts?
Let's just say there's a new adventurer in town. Wait a minute. I know that castle. It was there that day with her. Come on, we can go find her.
People of Fuzul. Today, citizens, I give you the all-purpose remedy to your boring and mundane lives. I have in my hands the detonator that will blow the magic out from under us. 5,000 channels. A picture in picture in picture in a picture.
I am Yagea, lost enchantress of the...
We covered that, didn't we? Yeah, well, hurry up, people. You gotta save the underground.
Oh, okay. Thanks. Because we were just gonna go home.
You're not hearing me. Will you take out that horrid Grand Inquisitor guy already?
Could you be a tad more specific?
Look, you have the 3 lost treasures of the high, middle, and deep magic. They have an order? What, do I have to spell it out for you? High magic. Hello? The radio tower is the highest point in Fuzul.
With the scroll, you can complete your quest. That's all I can tell you because, well,
that's all I know.
What? You take the tower. I have an irrational fear of heights. Cut the cable, I'll send the GI your way.
All right, we are back. We've got the 3 artifacts, and it looks like we're right where we need to be, too. Flathead Mesa. It's the Booznik scroll. It'll reverse the function of everything in your spellbook. Well, she must have given it to us for a reason. Okay, now you're extremely unattractive. Can we get on with this?
And allow 10 to 12 hours of dogma recitation.
Careful. That tent is filled with the Grand Inquisitor's personal guard.
What's your favorite poem?
I'm a real sucker for the romantics, I have to admit.
Oh, what kind of benefits package did the Grand Inquisitor promise you guys?
Pretty standard stock options package. 401k, profit sharing, but I won't be fully vested for another 3 months.
My broker told me that it's a bad time to invest in fanatical religions right now.
Say, Charlie, that's a nice vest.
Thanks. It's got a little tear, see? Right here. Not that you notice.
Crafty.
Sweet York, we're all gonna die!
Oh, merciful heavens, is this the end?
Try using the alarm clock on the door.
Oh, that's never gonna work. Who's gonna water my plants?
I can't breathe, the walls are closing in.
Let us out, let us out.
Please!
I hate adventurers.
Oh my god, they killed Kenny!
High Inquisition Rosal with evening appetite suppressants.
That was easy. Too easy. Uh-oh, my lantern sense is tingling again. Not bad, but it's still electrified. You are truly gifted, you know that?
Oh, people from the great underground empire, your wizards and enchanters, your conjurers and farmers, have held you for so long in their sway with the blasphemous black powers of magic long enough.
Oh, what a handy little nook.
You did not. Their power was your
hey, what's this big cube-shaped hole doing here?
They respected no persons. They held order and government in contempt. In short, they turned your empire into fudge. Not because they created fudge, but simply because they could and you could not.
When you see something like this, you just have to wonder, was all this pre-designed by some cosmic higher power?
This is how that great magic uprising came to happen. And what have we learned in the 100 years since the waning of magic? What are the 1,200 ships?
Uh-oh, it's crooked. It needs to be counterbalanced. Wait, put my lantern in the other cup to straighten it out. Everything's in place! All it would take now to finish things would be the casting of one incredibly appropriate and heretofore unused spell. Can't cast the spell! Too much interference! Yannix babbling! Too loud! Shut him up!
Avoid necessary pleasantries! Avoid vibration, avoid fermentation, avoid all these incarnations. Save often, floss regularly, floss athletically, and above all, never forget who is the boss of you. Often, floss regularly, floss meaningfully, floss athletically, and above all, never forget who is the boss of you. Me! I am the boss of you! I am the boss of you!
Hey, hey! Look! On the tower! That ain't the cable guy.
I don't think Jack was entirely clear on the plan. He just sent the Grand Inquisitor after us. You did great! I'll drop you a line from the ethereal planes.
This is the part where we kiss. Loyal subjects of the Empire, I hereby declare the underground open and magic free to all those who desire it. The Inquisition is no more!